And now a dormitory in a girls' public school.
Hello, Agnes? Agnes, are you awake? Agnes? Agnes?
Who is it? Is that you, Charlie?
Yeah, Agnes. Where's Jane?
I'm over here, Charlie. Jane, we're going down to raid the tuck shop.
Oh, good-o. Count me in, girls.
Can I come too, Agnes?
Yeah, Joyce. And me and Avril.
Yeah, Martha.
And Sookie.
Oh, wacko the diddle-o.
TV girls, here comes Miss Rogers.
All right, girls. Now stop this tomfoolery and get back into bed. Remember, it's the big match at St. Bridget's tomorrow.
Yes, on your screen tomorrow, the naughtiest girl in the school, starring the men of the 14th Marine Commando. And now it's documentary time, when we look at the momentous last years of the Second World War. And tonight, the invasion of Normandy, performed by the girls of Oakdean High School, Upper Fifth Science.
Come on, girls!
Dinners, I wish to join my husband, Admiral O.W.A. Giveaway, in condemning this shoddy misrepresentation of our modern Navy. The British Navy is one of the finest and most attractive and butchest fighting forces in the world. I love those white flared trousers and the feel of rough blue serge on those pert little buttocks.
I'm afraid we are unable to show you any more of that letter. We continue with a man with a stoat through his head. And now...
Still no sign of land. How long is it?
That's rather a personal question, sir.
You stupid bitch! I meant how long we've been in the lifeboat.
I spoil the atmosphere now.
I'm sorry.
Shut up! We'll have to start again.
Still no sign of land. How long is it?
33 days, sir.
33 days.
I don't think we can hold out much longer.
I don't think I did spoil the atmosphere.
Shut up!
I'm sorry, I don't think I did.
Of course you did!
Do you think I spoiled the atmosphere?
Well, I think
you're wrong. Shut up! Shut up!
Still no sign of land. How long is it?
33 days.
Can we start it again?
Oh!
Still no sign of land. How long is it?
33 days, sir.
33 days?
Yes. We can't hold out much longer. We haven't had any food since the fifth day.
We're done for! We're done for!
Shut up, Maudling! We've just got to keep hoping. Someone will find us.
How are you feeling, Captain? Not so good. I feel so weak.
We can't hold out much longer.
Listen, James. There's one last chance.
I'm done for. I've got a gammy leg and I'm going fast. I'll never get through, but...
Some of you might. So you'd better eat.
Eat you, son?
Yes, eat me.
With a gammy leg?
You don't have to eat the leg, Thompson. There's still plenty of good meat. Look at that arm.
It's not just the leg, son.
What do you mean?
Wash it. It's just that...
Why don't you want to eat me?
I'd rather eat Johnson, sir.
Oh, so would I, sir.
I see.
Well, that's settled. Everyone eats me.
Well, I, What's that? No, no. You go ahead. I won't.
Nonsense, sir. You're starving. Tuck in.
No, it's not just that. What's the matter with Johnson, sir? Well, he's not kosher.
Depends how we kill him, sir.
Yes, yes, I see that, but, well, to be quite frank, I like my meat a little more lean. I'd rather eat Hodges. Oh, well, all right.
No, I still prefer to eat Johnson. And we should all stop bickering and eat me.
Look, I tell you what. Why don't those of us who want to eat Johnson, then you, sir, can eat my leg, and then we can make a stock of the captain, and then after that we can eat the rest of Johnson cold for supper.
Good thinking, Hodges.
Finish off with peaches. Well, we can start off with the avocado.
Yes, the waitress. Waitress, we've decided now we're going to have our leg of Hodges.
Dear sir, I'm glad to hear that your studio audience disapproves of the last skit as strongly as I. As a naval officer, I abhor the implication that the Royal Navy is a haven for cannibalism. It is well known that we now have the problem relatively under control, and that it is the RAF who now suffer the largest casualties in this area. But what do you think the Argyles ate in Aden? Arabs? Yours, etc., Captain B.J. Smethig in a white wine sauce with shallots, mushrooms, and garlic.
Let's have a sketch about clean, decent human beings.
Morning.
Ah, good morning.
What will I do for you, Squaw?
Well, I wonder if you can help me. You see, my mother's just died.
Oh, yeah, we can help you. We deal with stiffs.
What?
Well, there are three things we can do with your mother. We can burn her, bury her, or dump her.
Dump her?
Dump her in the Thames.
What?
Oh, did you like her?
Yes.
Oh, well, we won't dump her then. Well, what do you think? We can bury her or burn her.
Well, which do you recommend?
Well, they're both nasty. If we burn her, she gets stuffed in the flames, crackle, 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 which is a bit of a shock if she's not quite dead, but quick. And then we give you a handful of the ashes, which you can pretend were hers.
Oh.
Or, gee. If we bury her, she gets eaten up by lots of weevils and nasty maggots. Which, as I said before, is a bit of a shock if she's not quite dead.
I see. Well, she's definitely dead.
Where is she?
No, she's in the set.
Come on! She looks quite young.
Yes, yes, she was.
Fred! Yeah? I think we've got Anita.
No!
What? I'll get the oven on.
Right.
Excuse me, are you suggesting eating my mother?
Yeah, not raw, cooked.
What?
Roasted, few French fries, broccoli, horseradish sauce.
Well, I do feel a bit peckish.
Great!
Can we have some parsnips?
Great, get some parsnips.
I really don't think I should.
Look, tell you what, we'll eat her. If you feel a bit guilty about it afterwards, we can dig a grave and you can throw up in it.